start our promotion celebration, I'd like to recall this year. We had school records broken, we had teams go undefeated, we had great academic achievement, we had students take classes at the high school. We had a lot of things to celebrate here at FCS. It was also filled with joy, and laughter, tears, and frustration. But you know what? You did it. You got to the end and you finished. It's really exciting, as a former coach for a long time, to get up and celebrate the moment of triumph. It just seems like yesterday you probably walked through the doors of FCS as little five-year-olds, and you rolled into kindergarten. And the same things in general that you learn in kindergarten are some great tools and some great life lessons to think about. So let's roll back the clock. Things I learned in kindergarten. Some basics. Share everything. Play fair. Don't hit people. Clean up your own mess, especially at home for your parents. Don't take things that aren't yours. Wash your hands before you eat. And especially boys, flush after use. These points began your journey here at FCS. And they mark by the end of tonight as you promote on into high school, which is very exciting. And I'm quite proud of each and every one of you because that's a milestone in your career. All paths lead somewhere. Which one will you take? Some of you will go on to college, some will go on to trade school, some of you will go out and work in the family business, some of you will go on the armed services. The sky's the limit. So as you move forward next and you follow that path that you desire, set your sights high, and your success will not only be in high school, but beyond that. So remember the words of actor Denzel Washington as you start high school. Nothing in life is worthwhile unless you take risks. Fall forward. Everything failed, every failed experiment is one step closer to success. So here to present our first class award is Ms. Van Buren and Ms. Sia.
Not crying. Our first set of awards tonight, or medals I should say, are going out to AVID students who have been exemplary in AVID for the past 3 years, I believe, all of them. They show AVID qualities of being a leader, being a hard worker, being organized in the AVID classroom, but also in all of their other classes as well. So each core class teacher has to sign off on these students receiving this medal. Sadly, not all of those that have been in AVID for 3 years will get this, but those that have worked very hard and shown that AVID leadership skills will be honored tonight. When you hear your name, please come up and get your medal. Tyler Lease. Destiny Drury. Maylin Williams. Ludwig. Elliot Henley. Victoria Smart. The Robert Johnson Athletic Award is Mr. Sticka.
Hi, I'm Mr. Sticka. I'm this year's Associate Principal. I'm so glad to be here this year. It's been a terrific year. I am pleased to present the Robert Johnson Athletic Award this evening. This award is given to the athlete who best displays the qualities of athleticism, coachability, sportsmanship, and also how well they support their teammates throughout the season. Typically, a student needs to participate in two sports during one school year to be eligible for this award. The FCS staff has voted, and we have two recipients this year. This year goes to two students, Malin Williams too. We have a plaque, Robert Johnson Athletic Award, and their names will be engraved in this very soon. Okay, next up is Heart of a Titan Award.
But the world that I'm presenting, this person would be behind me every step of the way because they have the heart of the Titan. And that's what the award is. Not only would they support me, but they would encourage me to do my best and to reassure me that it'll be all right. The Heart of the Titan is chosen by the secretaries, so I'm speaking on behalf of the secretaries. And they have the most impact in the school, kind of seen and not heard. The person nominated by every single staff member in the middle school, it was fairly unanimous. And not only did I vote for her, but I know that everybody here never doesn't see a smile on her face. And that person is Ashton Brown. Come on up.
She was a young lady with many talents. She was an athlete, an artist, a writer, and most importantly, a friend. She was never a person who judged others, gossiped, or made another person feel rejected. She was accepting and welcoming of everyone she met. Each year since her untimely passing, the FCS staff has chosen an eighth grader who embodies the qualities that made Katie so special. As you can imagine, middle school is a rough time period for many students. There are just not that many middle schoolers anywhere that have these qualities yet. Typically, these qualities come with time, life experience, and perspective. I know that I certainly was not the best version of myself when I was in the eighth grade. I was a selfish, gossiping girl with a pretty big attitude. There was no way that I would have been worthy of receiving an award like this. That is why I think I have so much respect for this year's recipient. In the 3 years I have known this person, I have never heard him say a negative word about another human being. I have witnessed him encouraging his fellow students. I have watched him be accepting of students that others had rejected. He takes the high road when someone wrongs him and is always graciously willing to accept an apology. His positive attitude has cheered me many times when I was feeling pretty low. This student is so remarkable to me because already as an eighth grader, he is the type of person I've been working to be my whole life. I truly hope that his classmates appreciate what they have in him. It is my great honor to present this year's Katie Boris Award to Michael Baker. We have the Nanette LaRue Citizenship Award given by Mr. Hart.
Thank you. Man, I love this job. So, we got a little bit of business to take care of before we go to the Citizenship Award. There are some moms in this room who we need to thank, because if you haven't looked around and see how amazing this gym is, they did a phenomenal job. They have been raising money. They've been doing a great job. Some of those moms are here. Let's see, we have Miss Roberta Ashlock, Miss Carol Ashworth, Miss Heidi Huffman, Miss Vicki Williams. One who likes to hang in the background, but we wouldn't have had an 80s dance without her, Donna Sampson. Amanda Wofford has done a lot as well. Again, this class would not be where they are without the support in these seats, and they know that. We've spent 9 months talking about it, and they completely agree, and they are very thankful that you're behind them, no doubt about it. Now let's put the eighth grade to the test. Eighth graders, if you finished this year with a 4.0, please stand. Well, yes, you do. You know who you are. Stand up. Stand up, white folks. Tyler. Taylor Huffman, Tyler Lees, Alexa Hermans have not only got a 4.0, they have done very well all year long. But I'm intentionally not talking about you yet. You think I'm going to forget the incomparable Malin Williams? I saved you for last, because Malin, has there been a term since you've been in middle school where you did not get straight A's? No. Malin has had a 4.0 for 3 years. Very well done, all of you. Thank you. So now, let's get to the Citizenship Award. The Citizenship Award is a fun award because it's named after Nanette LaRue, who lives two blocks that way. When I was first hired here, I had Nanette's grandson as one of my students, and he was a challenge, and he was a spitfire, and he was a great kid. One of his favorite pastimes was riding his bike the length of the roof of the old building. Yeah, I found that out one weekend. It was pretty entertaining. Nanette has given to this community for years, and she does so thanklessly and tirelessly. She is there for anyone who has needed her over the years. She is a citizen, and we could not be more honored to have her affiliated with the school for so many years. The student who's receiving this award definitely picks up that legacy and carries it. We talk often about how these eighth graders come in at sixth grade as learners and they leave as leaders. And this student most definitely has. When you talk to the staff, when you talk to her peers, when you talk to most of the people in this room, this name just brings a smile to people's faces because they're so impressed with her and what she has done. Not only that, it's amazing how many staff members we're so excited to hear that she got this award because it is so deserved because she's such an amazing citizen and our school is a better place because she is in it. Ladies and gentlemen, the 2016 Nanette LaRue Citizenship Award goes to Destiny Drew. Award that we changed the name of in the last couple of years, the Patricia Woodstock Roxanne Henley Academic Award, please welcome Miss Sydney Zeal.
So the Patricia Woodstock Roxanne Henley Academic Award goes to two students each year, one boy and one girl, who show total academic excellence in all subjects and all areas. We're talking about kids who come to class on time, their work when asked, who keep their grades up in school, all their grades, no matter what's going on in their lives, no matter what's distracting them, who really believe that school is important and try to do their best every single day. So this year, I'm really excited to announce that the winners for the Patricia Woodstock and Roxanne Henley Award are Alexa Hermans and Tyler Lees.
The Principal's Award was created back in 2005 to recognize the students who have really come a long way since they started middle school. Many of our students have truly taken big steps towards young adulthood over the course of their 3 years, and and I have to rely on the staff, since it's my first year, to recollect on these changes. So, these young people have improved their level of maturity, how they conduct themselves in the classroom, how they walk down the hall, how they talk to adults, how they talk to their peers. This year's winner is a great example of how incredible that change can be. As a sixth grader, the transition of being upstairs with multiple teachers and a whole new set of expectations was indeed a challenge for him. And some days, just spending the entire day in the classroom was a big success for him. Today, he sits before us as a rather mature eighth grader who is not only a two-sport athlete, but a student has made great strides in the classroom. Ladies and gentlemen, your 2016 Principal's Award winner, William Flynn.
Next up, we have a class speaker. We have one of our eighth grade students coming up and sharing with you all. I've been really looking forward to this. Please welcome Destiny Drury.
I would like to take a moment to thank first my classmates for choosing me for this honor. I would also like to thank all of our friends and family for being here to show their support for us. I know there were also many people who could not be here today, but we would not be here without their support as well, and we are very thankful to all of them. First, let me say, this is only the beginning to a new chapter in our story. There is still so much more you can write, and you can never give up. Just ask Dr. Seuss. When things start to happen, don't worry, don't stew, just go right along, you'll start to happen too. Our years here at FCS have been great. We have lost friends and gained friends. Some friends have even been reconnected. In the years that I have been here, I have learned what it's like to go to school with almost all the same people year after year. I have also learned what it's like to have teachers that will care and will dedicate their time to help you get the education you need. Honestly, when I look back on it, our middle school years are my favorite. There are people you'll meet as you go along. They will help you know right, they will help you know wrong. I think I speak for all of us when I say thank you to the staff. You guys are always here and help us. You help us with our schoolwork, and you see more in us than what others would. You believed in us, and you guys are why we are here today. The student-teacher relationship in this school is amazing. There are a few teachers I would personally like to thank for you for believing in me. My fifth grade teacher, Ms. Clark, always saw what I was capable of. She told my dad and I about AVID. Thanks to her, I am stronger in my subjects, and AVID has helped me get ready for a higher education. Ms. Van Buren, you have been here for me since day one of sixth grade. It is great having a teacher like you. You have helped me improve my writing and pushed me to the best I could be. You have an amazing bond with your students that you don't see many teachers have. Mr. Hart, when I walked into your class last year, I had little to no interest in history. Things change, and now I absolutely love it thanks to you. Every day, I walk in expecting to learn and have a great time. You are one of the teachers that sees greatness and success in our class, and you never give up on us. You know what your students are capable of, and you make those capabilities stronger. We wouldn't be the students we are today without any of the teachers in this room. Thank you, fellow eighth graders, for being amazing and always trying your hardest. Each of you has made a name for yourself as an individual. I have tried to get to know all of you, and you are all perfect in your own way. If you guys set your mind to it, you will all go far. I want to thank the people that are here for me no matter what. You guys have helped me in the past years a lot. No matter what's going on, always be as strong as you can and never lose sight of what's important. Every one of you guys has the potential to be successful, but to do that, you have to start thinking about who can drag you down and who can help you along the way. We aren't done yet. Keep up the amazing work you've done. We have all grown so close, it's as if we're family now. You'll join the high flyers who soar to high heights. You won't lag behind because you'll have the speed. You'll pass the whole game and soon take the lead. Whether it's on the field, court, or track, our class has dominated. Our football team went undefeated, and volleyball worked their butts off. When you ask the boys on our football team what they remember, most would say they went undefeated. But one person that I asked said he remembers all the work they put into win every game in their season. Our girls' basketball team went and gave everything we could this season. There were tears and there were cheers, but most of all, we grew. Our boys' basketball team worked hard for every win they got, but most importantly, they grew, not only as individuals, but as a team. At the beginning of the season, they walked in knowing nothing about their coach. They walked away not only better, but ready for high school. The track team was the best by far this year, though. They, as a team, walked away district champions of 2016. Both boys and girls worked their butts off to get there, and they won on our track for the last time as middle school. To think this is the last time we will wear a Titan jersey is sad, but for some, this year was the last year they will wear a Sheridan school jersey. Our class may seem a little crazy to some, but it takes real talent and real dedication like our teachers have to want to prove others wrong. You have brains in your head, feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself in any direction you choose. Our class is a successful and smart class. In social studies, we began by realizing what was really going on here before Columbus, what it would take for the U.S. to expand into the future, and even what might cost the next civil war. In language arts, we have learned how to become better writers. Since the first day of sixth grade, we have grown in our writing. In math, we spent a lot of our year looking at linear equations. As we got closer to the end of the year, we learned about the Pythagorean theorem. In science, we have succeeded at getting workshop up and running. Even if people didn't like it, they did their work. Earlier in the year, we had a section dedicated to magnets and electricity. In that section, we had some fun and hands-on labs dealing with magnets and how they power things. This year, our test scores improved a lot, but that couldn't have happened without student effort or our teachers' effort. They always dedicate their time to our education. Thank you guys for making us smarter over these past few years. Guys, we all climbed that mountain together, and each one of us has made our school better in our own way. But now it's up to the next class to add on to that success. We can't begin and end with FCS, though. We need to take all our success to high school next year and show them who the best class is. No matter what high school our future holds for us, as we walk away today, it is important for us to remember the times we had and the relationships we built. Together, we are the class of 2020, the class that will clearly succeed and never give up. You've gone through the middle, and now you're on top. It's time to head to high school and show them what you got.
Thank you, Destin. This year, the students got together and voted on who they wanted to be for their staff speaker. There might have been some lobbying that took place, but one woman has held the souls of these eighth graders in her heart for 3 years, and she is gonna have a tough time saying goodbye to them, but she's honored to be the speaker that they nominated to speak in promotion. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Ms. Robin Van Buren.
To follow. I have to be honest with you all tonight. Writing this speech was a struggle for me. How do I put into words 3 years of teaching these students in a row? What message do I want to leave you with tonight? How will I avoid crying because I know all of my students are betting on that happening? Well, after drafting about 5 different versions, I decided I wanted to leave you here tonight with a final reminder of just how amazing this group of eighth graders that sits here before us tonight is. I first got introduced to this group as they walked through my classroom door as scared sixth graders about 3 years ago. Another batch of new middle schoolers with too much energy and not enough deodorant. Normally, that would not faze me. It was, after all, my third year in a row as a sixth grade teacher. The difference this year was that I was barely pregnant and hardly able to look at food without turning green. Add to that a class size of 33, and you've got a recipe for disaster. So, in my nauseous state of mind, I told myself, this year might just be about survival. Little did I know that this was the year I would not only have a son, but about 60 plus other kids who would become my school family. This group of sixth graders was different from the start. They were rambunctious and more independent than my students in the past have been. I knew I would have to earn their trust before I could truly get them to work for me. Some were easier to win over than others, but slowly we started to build a community in sixth grade and their growth started to show. Over the next 2 years, I continued to be amazed by this group. Most of them are not only great athletes, academically talented, or just overall good people, but also strong individuals. Growing up in this world isn't always easy, but it seems that life has thrown a few of these kids sitting in front of us a few extra curveballs. I have seen some of you overcome the loss of family members. Many of you have a parent that is no longer in your life for one reason or another. Some of you have seen your parents struggle and wonder how they will put food on the table or pay the bills. Some of you have even seen addiction impact those who you love. And yet, you get yourselves to school and continue to pull through because you choose not to let the hardships stop you. It is this fighting spirit that I love most about this group, and I truly believe that if you guys channel this energy in the right direction and take life's hardships as a challenge to become better, there is no limit to what you can achieve. So here is my advice for you tonight. First off, work hard. Great things in life don't come easy. You have to work hard to achieve your goals. Second, have fun. High school goes by quick and will be challenging, but if you don't remember to enjoy yourself, you will regret it. Third, don't lose your feistiness. Even though it drives your teachers and parents crazy, it is what makes you guys stand out from the crowd. And lastly, look out for each other. Like I have told many of you in the past, you have enough working against you. You don't need to add tearing each other down to the list. Support each other these next 4 years. Continue to be a part of this family we have created here at school. Sadly, our time together has come to an end. We have prepared you as best we can for this next chapter in your life. And it is now time for you to show the rest of the world how amazing you are. And those of you who accuse me of having favorites, I think it's time you know the truth. You are all my favorites. I hope that you all know that. And even though I'm the one who's supposed to be the teacher, you guys have taught me more than I could ever teach you. This group will forever hold a place in my heart. And I will be at your high school graduation like an obnoxious school mother cheering the loudest, because I will always be your supportive teacher, even when you are not in my class.
Now for our main event, the presentation of certificates for our 8th grade students. First row. Destiny Marie Drury. Caleb Sean Hess.
Amelia Yasmin Ayala. Colin Jamie Tucker. Ashton Jade Brown Allenson. Liliana Rose Samora. Tyler James Lease. Michaela Marie Windham. Brandon Jeffrey Ashlock. Riley Arlene Simpson. Isaka Patience Rain Pacheco. Isaac Padilla. Alexis Marie Jones Nair. Nakona Lee Littlejohn. Kaya Tomilson Davis. Zim Ludwig. Alyssa Irene Assumption. Dielden Polk. Felicia Ebensteiner. Taylor Hank Thomas Huffman. Kylie McCarrigan. Caden Jedediah Daniel Eggers. Alyssa Ann Oldham. Michaela Brianna Nelson Ullery. Gayla Mary Quamps Burnside.
Reese Freeman. Elliot Don Henley. Alexa Ray Hermans. Maylin Joy Williams. Wyatt Daniel Lee Schultz. Riley Durth. Giovanna Guardiola. Joshua Mudd. Sage Morrison Fleury. Wyatt Kirk Hulse. Mackenzie Marie Wofford. Hunter Richter. Amalia Cheyenne Hawkins. Chandler Campos. Nathan Bennett. Ariana and Selena Garcia. Devin Earnhardt Drader. Mai Kaneko. Gabriel David Kidwell Andreas. Victoria K. Smart. Calvin Moa. Stephanie Leanne Nelson Sampson. Xavier Allen Holt. Megan Ellenwood. Michael Kanan Foster. Kalea Lynn Alexandria Himes Ashworth. Tegan Scott Thomas Eggers. T.
Talia Jean Marie Bidwell. Dakota Don Tippler. Shayla Cuomo. William Richard Flynn. Jesus Ortega Rivera. Justin Blake Collins Lauer. Noah Dallas. Josh Gurman. And our last student this evening, Sierra Resendez.
So let's give our eighth graders a huge round of applause. Wow, it's just been an awesome evening, and I really appreciate all of you coming out tonight. Most importantly, thank you, eighth graders. It's been a lot of fun this year, learned a lot. And best wishes as you promote on up to SHS or wherever life takes you. I'd like to conclude with a quote from one of my favorite authors. Not that just really depicts all coaches, but Dr. Seuss. Don't cry because it's over. Smile because it happened. So I present you this year's eighth grade class.